Hello, everyone. My name is Peter Walts, Chief Operating Officer for the Employment Law Alliance. We're here in New York City today at the world headquarters for Kroll Corporation, speaking with Dan Karson, their chairman. Dan and Kroll are charter members of the Service Provider Alliance, or the SPA program here at the ELA. And we're going to talk more about the services that Kroll provides, get some insight into how they work closely with our attorneys and what the opportunities are. Dan Karson, by way of background, has over 40 years' experience in investigating business crimes, spent a lot of his time in the city of New York as the Assistant Commissioner of the Department of Investigations, as well as an Assistant District Attorney in the Bronx, where he served as the Chief of Narcotics Investigations. I had early discussions with Dan as we were conceiving this program, and he was very, very helpful and insightful, telling us about how the interface between the employment lawyers around the world and his firm works. Let's welcome Dan to the program. So welcome, Dan.
Thank you, Peter.
Looking forward to hearing more about Kroll. Could you give our members just a brief background on how Kroll got started, what its background is, and where it is today?
Kroll was founded in 1972. It actually began as a consulting firm providing information and advice to the printing industry on how to save money by cutting costs. Early in that period, our members then found that a lot of what went into cost increases and price overcharging in the printing industry was the result of criminal activity, kickbacks paid to individuals who were purchasing goods and services for those companies. And that's when the light bulb went off, and we found that this was a service that was translatable across not just in the printing and paper industry, but in other industries as well. And Kroll began to conduct internal investigations of business crimes and then broadened its services to the theft of intellectual property, to contests for corporate control, and eventually got in on the ground floor of cybercrime when business machines and computers began to play an increasingly more important role in the storage of information and, of course, in communications.
So I would imagine that Kroll works closely with a lot of employment attorneys. So why should an employment attorney call Kroll, and what do those situations look like?
An employment attorney is usually contacted by its client firm when some act of wrongdoing has been committed. An employee has stolen money or inventory or sold critical data such as customer data or employee information, or there has been an intrusion of some kind at the lawyer's client firm. The first 24 and 48 hours of an investigation are critically important, and that's where Kroll can be of great importance or great help to an employment law firm.
Dan, I'd like to talk about investigations. I know Kroll is used in many cases in global investigations. It's a primary service you provide your clients. But our employment lawyers around the globe also do investigations, and I need to understand the nuances. Do you compete with our members, or is it complementary? How does it work?
We don't compete with members, and we want very much to emphasize that we are a resource for the members, for the law firms. We are not competing. We are not replacing. We are providing expertise which helps the members serve their clients. We have resources around the world. We have investigative strategies that we believe can help our clients render legal advice to their clients. We are not a law firm. We are an investigations firm. And members should have no concern whatsoever that they are going to be shunted to the sidelines or that they are not going to be playing the leading role in representing their clients.
Well, that's good news, because I know that clients often look to our attorneys for recommendations and advice on what they should do in an investigation. So Dan, what's the value add that Kroll brings to an investigation? What's different about the Kroll components of investigations to what our labor and employment attorneys do?
The value added that Kroll brings is moving swiftly to retrieve incriminating information, incriminating evidence, preserving data, and conducting interviews in a very short space of time. But more than that, anywhere in the world. We are an international organization. We have offices and language capabilities all over the world. So what we do is lend to an employment law firm an extension or the ability to move swiftly anywhere in the world and provide experienced professionals who can conduct cybercrime investigations, retrieve data, and gather facts in order to make critical decisions early in the process.
Well, that was one of the things that really attracted the ELA to Kroll. They have offices, I think, in over 50 countries and speak multiple languages. There's thousands of people on the ground in country. And that's a benefit that the ELA has also, because we're using local counsel. Take us through, if you could, Dan, what some of the initial steps are in an investigation when Kroll gets involved.
Number one, of course, is sitting down with our client and getting an explanation of what the facts are in a particular case. It could be the theft of critical data, the theft of intellectual property. It could be an allegation that employees are getting kickbacks for the purchase of goods and services, or it could be an accounting defalcation resulting in the loss or potential loss of hundreds of thousands or at times millions of dollars. Once we have the facts in hand, the next important step is conduct a background investigation of the employees. There usually are one or more suspect employees. What is going on in their lives? Is there a criminal conviction? Is there serious debt? Are they living beyond their means? Are they using email or are they using social networks to export data that it belongs to the company out of the organization? We may need also to retrieve data. We can image a hard drive. We can look at telephone communications. We can look at email and determine whether who's involved, how many are involved, and effectively seal off the exits and prevent further loss. The other critical thing is obtaining and preserving critical data before it is erased and destroyed, or in circumstances where there has been some attempt to delete or erase data, we can use software to retrieve it. It also involves determining who are the critical individuals to individual, who are the friendly witnesses, who are the subjects of investigation, and again, moving swiftly to mitigate our client's loss and give them the options to bring civil action or, in cases, to go to law enforcement.
So Dan, it sounds like technology is playing more and more of a role than ever before in what investigations need to be successful.
Technology walks in lockstep with crime. Crime walks in lockstep with technology. Every advance in technology provides individuals, be they hackers or people who are stealing from their company, another way to steal money. So the use of technology is involved in defrauding a company, but it is critically involved in helping a company recover. So for example, we used to say that people took their deepest, darkest secrets and put it on company email. Now they are putting it on social networking sites. So they're using Facebook, they're using Snapchat, they're using other social networks to communicate with their friends, with their relatives, and they often are careless about what they say. It is often an opportunity for us to obtain critical evidence, and it may or may not surprise you to know that half or more people who have social networking accounts do not password protect them, which makes them part of the open market, and it is not subject to any privacy privilege.
Very interesting. You know, we had our recent conference in Buenos Aires this year, and one of the topics was social media and the practices within the different jurisdictions, and I was really amazed to see how diverse they were from country to country, where in some cases the privacy of the individual was extremely limited, and in other cases the government stood behind the organization to allow them to have full access to people's records. So do you find as you move through the world that you're faced with different regulations for each jurisdiction that would allow you access to the social information?
Most definitely, and in fact that I believe is also a value that we can bring to our clients, because operating in these different theaters every day, we are sensitive to and aware of what the legal restrictions are in obtaining data. We know that in the United States, if an individual joins a company and signs the confidentiality statement and signs the employee rules of conduct, in most cases they are waiving the right to any claim of privacy when they are using company email, when they are using company devices. In France, you cannot get access to an employee's email for investigative purposes, even with the employee's consent. It's governed by law, and that is typical in different countries in the European community, and it varies from, again, country to country.
See, this is fascinating because I think the great opportunity between a partnership between the ELA and Kroll is that our local council brings the local legal perspective to that, and you bring the criminal and global perspective to that, criminal investigation, global perspective to that. When our attorneys are working on an investigation, what are some of the steps they should take to make sure they preserve evidence in an investigation so that when your organization comes in, you have the tools at the ready?
Number one, don't turn on any machines.
Leave all the machines off.
Don't touch them. The mere act of turning on a computer can have the effect of erasing data. So what we tell our clients is protect the machines, lock them up, guard them, the suspect employee's computer. Also, suspend the practice or the deletion schedule for data off the server, because there can be information on a PC that has been erased or effectively deleted, or the PC may be lost and not retrievable, but it may sit on the server. Most companies have a policy whereby every 3 months, 6 months, 9 months, data is being steadily deleted. We say suspend that process so we can have an opportunity to go back and retrieve evidence. Often we are doing a look back. We are not necessarily investigating an ongoing crime. We're investigating something that took place 6 months ago, a year ago. So that's important. Next, don't interview anybody. Talk to us first. Let's talk about a strategy before we go forward and start interviewing people. You might be tipping off someone who is then going to despoil evidence or in effect walk away. So those are a couple of very important steps. And preserve paper, preserve anything that might be evidence of a crime or evidence of wrongdoing.
And having Kroll as a strategic partner is certainly going to become an important part of what we can offer our clients to help them solve those problems.
And likewise, I should add, Peter, that we frequently get the first call. And our clients often ask us, who can you recommend as a law firm to represent us in this situation? Because we have to make a decision, a hire fire decision or a suspend terminate decision in an, when it comes to a suspect employee, or we have a strategy that we've got to devise, and we are frequently in the position where we are recommending a law firm, and we would be very happy to recommend members of the Alliance.
Well, this has been very helpful. I'm also noticing that there's a report that you bring out every year. I'm looking at the annual edition of the Global Fraud Report. Could you just give us a little bit of background on the kind of data you prepare? Because I know this will be available to the ELA members and their clients through the Employment Law Alliance website when you go to the Kroll Service Provider Alliance page. Give us some insight into what's in this document.
We write the Global Fraud Report every year in partnership with the Economist Intelligence Unit. What we're looking for are trends in business crimes on a worldwide basis. What's trending up? What's trending down? What should companies be more alert to? And invariably, crimes of technology are on the rise because of the increasing sophistication of business information systems. We know that financial crimes are increasing, particularly there's been a strange, odd combination of technological crime and old-fashioned fraud in companies who have been conned or fooled into wire transferring sometimes millions of dollars out of accounts by individuals who have first hacked into the exchange server, determined who sits in the treasury function, created a look-alike email domain, and then communicated with treasury officials, getting them to think that they are getting legitimate instructions to wire money out. That's a combination of the very old and the very new. It's cost business around the world something in the neighborhood of $12 billion the last 2 years, successfully pulling off these frauds. So what we try to do in the fraud report is cherry pick out these trends in business crime and alert our clients to what to look out for and to arm themselves to prevent this from happening to them. And then we slice and dice it according to region, according to business, and according to subject matter crime.
Well, it's a very valuable document and one that I know our members and their clients are going to benefit from. And I think this is just the tip of the iceberg of what Kroll and the Employment Law Alliance can do to partner together to help our clients, our shared clients around the world, be a safer place. So I appreciate your time and attention to this, and we're very happy to have Kroll as a part of our organization.
And we're very proud and pleased to be part of the organization as well. Thank you, Peter.
Great. Thanks for joining us, Dan. So on behalf of the Employment Law Alliance, please check out our website, employmentlawalliance.com. Go to the Service Provider Alliance page to learn more about Kroll and our other Service Provider Alliance partners. This is an opportunity for us to help broaden the practice of your firm and your clients by bringing these valuable services to bear when they're most needed. On behalf of the ELA, thank you very much for joining us, and we'll talk soon.